we also need to see the report, because it may be that Mueller decided not to prosecute for obstruction of justice for various reasons, that there wasn't proof beyond a reasonable doubt of some things, but there still may have been proof of some very bad deeds and very bad motives, and we need to see that.
There's Jerry Nadler, House Judiciary Committee Chair. He's not going to let go of this now for seeing the full Mueller report. We'll see in the end whether or not he wins that argument. Well, hang on. I haven't introduced you yet.
Oh, my God. I'm so angry at him.
With anticipation building in Washington, let me bring in Alan Dershowitz now. He wrote the book against impeaching President Trump. How you doing?
I'm doing good.
But you got to wait your turn on this show.
Oh, I appreciate that.
Now, go ahead. What were you saying about
that? Well, would he have said the same thing if Comey started talking about Hillary Clinton? Yeah, there wasn't enough evidence to go after her, but maybe she really did some terrible, terrible things. Do I remember correctly when Comey said that she had engaged in extreme carelessness, that people like Nadler and others went after him, saying that's not the role of the prosecutor? The role of the prosecutor is to say, indict or not indict. You don't start expressing opinions about the bad things people did about which there wasn't probable cause or proof beyond a reasonable doubt.
Or until you even see the report itself.
The double standard is unbelievable.
Go back to the point he is making. Will he see the redactions removed in whatever form they arrive this week?
He'll see a great deal. I think the redactions will be few and far between. They are necessary under the law. There'll be enough. And the real question is, why do we have a double standard? Why were we all so furious, and I was certainly furious, when Comey went after Hillary Clinton beyond saying we're not going to indict her, and now we want to hear everything about everybody who is in the report, even though they haven't been indicted? Where does that double standard come from?
That's Washington, D.C., and
course.
I think you know it, right?
Yeah.
There's a good write-up today in the Wall Street Journal about how Bill Barr's team has been getting ready, really for a week now, to deliver the Mueller report. What are you, take our viewers inside of your brain when you receive the report. What are you looking for?
Well, I look for two things. First, I will skim quickly the Russia matter because I will conclude probably that there's no evidence there. That looks like a complete exoneration. Then the most interesting thing will be to look at obstruction of justice. And you're going to have two reports. Two reports. In 55 years of practicing law, I've never seen that by a prosecutor. Two reports. Half the people on the Mueller team will say the president was guilty of obstruction of justice. Half the people will say he wasn't guilty or there was insufficient evidence. And Mueller will say, whoops, I couldn't decide, so I handed it over to the attorney general. So I want to read both of those reports. I don't think we're going to get new facts, because the obstruction case is based largely on what the president said openly in tweets and in press conferences. I think we're going to see a different analysis of the law as to whether a president can commit obstruction of justice if he fires somebody like Comey, who he's entitled to
fire.
What's
important about the two reports? Why is that?
Because you're going to have conflicting reports. You're going to have one report saying he's guilty, one report saying he's not guilty. Who's ever heard of a prosecutor or a special counsel issuing that kind of on the one hand and on the other hand? Sounds like a law professor.
Back in the Wall Street Journal piece here today, it says Rudy Giuliani is preparing a rebuttal. It's now at 140 pages. He wants to get it down to 50 pages. What argument does he make?
Well, he's absolutely right. There should be a rebuttal, and it should have been issued simultaneously with the report, because the report's going to be a one-sided prosecutorial report, and then you should have a one-sided defense report. That's the way the adversarial system operates. So it's a good thing for America to hear both sides of the issue and to hear them as quickly as they can together. So I would hope that the Giuliani report comes out very quickly after the Mueller report comes out.
Could be
so
simultaneous.
It would be great. I don't know that they know enough about what's in it simultaneous.
That's a good point. You're writing an introduction based on the Mueller report?
That's right, yeah. And you know, I'm going to look at the whole Mueller report and then do an analysis of putting it in context. Should we have had a special counsel? Should these pieces of information be released? I'm going to try to put it in a legal and political, mostly a legal context.
Can I get you on one more question on Jerry Nadler? Yesterday on that Sunday show, he talked about the word spying. He said it was unfortunate Bill Barr should not have used it. It was complete and total nonsense, is the phrase that he used yesterday. He said what he meant to say was executing judicially ordered warrants.
Well,
you're a lawyer.
Yeah.
Cut through that.
Well, if the FBI had gone into the Hillary Clinton campaign, you'd see Nadler saying spying, spying. You'd see the Republicans saying judicially ordered warrants. I mean, both sides have a way of twisting language and using language to their advantage. Intrusion is probably the best word.
Is there a difference, yes or no?
Well, I think he should have used the word intrusion. There was an intrusion, or let's have an investigation to see whether there's intrusion into the campaign. All we have now is an allegation.
I think you're going to get that investigation. Bill Barr pointed to that. Thank you, sir. You come on back, all right?
Appreciate it. Alan Dershowitz. Thank you.